Jack, who did all the artwork on your jacket?
Okay, the chap's name was Arthur Dimple. He was from California. And he would paint these things on you. He charged you for it. Mm. And he had a lady there in England someplace, I don't know the lady's name or whatever. She made these patches that we would put on there. This patch here with Alley-Oop on it, on that right dinosaur. A fellow from North Carolina called me one day and wanted to buy that patch.
How did he know about it?
Well, he got my name from someplace that I had a jacket from one of the reunions. Somebody from North Carolina was probably at the union. And they said, Jack Spratt's got a jacket with the original Alley-Oop patch. He said, it's a, like from sheepskin. It's. And he said, it's painted as Alley-Oop, and he's riding on a animal. And he said, I'll send you a blank check and you can fill in the amount you want. I said, well, it's not worth nothing to me. It's mine. I don't want to sell it. He said, well, I still got his phone number, but I'm never going to sell it.
And then it's too sentimental.
They put the 35 missions of the bombs over here. Oh, yeah. And the guy said, well, I said, well, put the other four. He said, they won't match up, which would make it 39. He said, but we will put a thing above it. Now, is that's my name, or is that the mouse?
That's the mouse.
That's the mouse.
And the mouse is you.
And the mouse is me, because whenever we weren't flying and we get up and they would say, well, the mission might be aborted. So I would always lay down in a corner or wherever we were at and go to sleep. So they call me Sleepy. Thank you. John, you're getting me all the time. And this chap that painted this on, it's amazing. He was from Los Angeles. He is at Hollywood there. And he was painting for whoever the person was out there, you know. And he was making like...
Walt Disney.
Yeah. He was making like $30,000 or $40,000 a year. He was very bitter about being drafted into service, going from $40,000 a year to $21 a month. I would have been pretty bitter, too. I only lost... I only was getting $144 a month. But he did that. But he charged everybody for that. He charged about, at the time, the pound was only worth about a dollar, I think, a dollar and a quarter. He would charge you 10 pounds to put that on your jacket.
A lot of money in those days.
Yeah.
But still.
He went away pretty wealthy. He put lots of pictures on lots of guys' jackets, painted them on the planes. And
will it fit you, Jack?
I haven't had it on. What it is, Don, it's shrunk so much from leather will do that.
Yeah.
What I should have been doing each year. I was going to treat it, and I figured, no, I'm going to keep it in its originality. Now you can see inside, John, where somebody, if you didn't have your name in it, somebody would like it better than you.
Mm.
So I put my name right there. Now put it, I don't know. It was a 36, but I think I'm about a 40 now. We'll see here. Maybe I'll slither in, get part of me in it. I'll let me. But I've shrunk quite a bit. Get that arm in there. Oh, buddy.
Whoa.
Maybe. No, I can't do it. Well, maybe. Let's see how I get squeezed in this. Oh, goodness. That's going to be a squeeze. But you know, when I wore this jacket, it was 150.
And you're not 150 now.
No, I'm only 130.
It's that big buckle, I think.
Pull it in, Jack.
Pull it in.
When wow. I'm that's like being an apple tart stuffed in it.
Wow, like look that? At oh, that. God.
When's the last time you wore that?
When I came home at out of
really?
Service, 19, well, we came home
you
in 45.
Put it on since
never
then?
Had it on since.
Well, turn around, oh. Turn so, around, Jack Spratt.
I want to tell you this much, John. This is the original look. Mm. Never been anything done to it. With the 39 missions on it.
You and see, it's 68 years old. Well, more
you
than
see
that.
See the cuff.
Yeah.
Somebody said, well, take that and have it fixed. Yeah. I said, no.
Hold on.
I said, you're taking evaluation with. Now, I probably got that hung up someplace in there.
Yeah.
But, in the turret.
But I never, the kids, I say that my children, Jack, which is a boy, you know, he wanted to put this jacket on and a German helmet I got it that I can't find now. It's in this house someplace, but I can't find it. And the German snuck in and got it. But he would put this jacket on and put that helmet on and go down the street on his bicycle.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. And he'd say, I'm also German and also American, you know. But you can see it. It's only a 36 now. I'm about 40. But it still fits. I didn't think I could get it.
Yeah.
Turn around, Jack.
40. Yeah. Across my shoulders.
Yeah.
I might not be that now, though, because I've...
Heavens above.
I shrunk 2 inches or so. The doctor had my height when I... Last time he took me, he had a height at 6'8" when the last time he checked me, and it was 6 foot... I mean, five. 5 foot, six and... 6.5 inches, so it was 56.
Did you have your hat?
No, I had one of those, and then I had one of the other ones. And
as you just said, Wendy, heavens above. Heavens that was above. That was Jack's play.
That was the original play.
Right. Heavens above.
Yeah. And when the kids used to play, they would take the caps and things, and pretty soon they wore out. Yeah, I could go to an wonderful army place and buy one, but I said I used to have my coveralls. Where that ribbon I showed you to cut on them, and they just disintegrated. I mean, really.
So when you're in the ball turret, you had that on, and you had your khaki pants, and then you'd have a sheepskin.
No, couldn't wear it in there.
You couldn't wear it in there, so you went up just with that on to minus 50.
It was the heated suit underneath.
Oh, the heated suit. Yeah, yeah.
First time when we were flying in the States at high altitude, that's when we had the sheepskin. Mm. Things, and we didn't have to wear them in the latter in 1944 because they discontinued that. They went into the heated silk.
What about gloves?
Leather gloves, and they were heated, and they would snap onto the end of the uniform that you had, and the pants snapped onto the top.
And then that jacket went over the top.
Yeah. I wore this for 39 missions. Well, you can tell, and I never... I wouldn't let the kids play with it very much. It's just been like this since...
That's wonderful. It's fantastic.
It's tight now. I don't know, being at 150... Well, of course, this leather.
It's all those leather bars.
And I never... You can take and treat it, and it would have been real soft and everything. But I said, then I take the originality away from it. I said, people see this, they want to buy it right off. Give it, I'll buy that. I said, you don't want that.
It's no amount of money
I said, I said, it'll stay in the family till eternity. I said, it'll go to my son and it'll go to his son. Does that have the emblem on the shoulder?
Yeah.
Oh, the 8th Air Force?
Yeah.
Over here.
Yeah.
You need a light on?
No, it's fine.
I always like this little mouse.
Yeah. I like the little mouse.
Look how nice and clear it shows
up. I know.
Yeah. Can you see it?
Oh, yes.
It shows up much clearer, doesn't it?
Yeah, doesn't it? How's the 8th show up over there? How's the alley-oops show up on? Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that guy.
Doesn't that show up nice?
Oh, beautiful. I'll bet there's not very many of those around anymore. No. That guy called me and he said, Jack, he said, I just got to have that patch that you got on the jacket.
He's probably a collector.
I said, he probably was. And he said, do you want to sell the jacket? And I said, neither one are for sale. He said, what are you going to do with it? And I said, well, I got a son and I got grandsons and that. And I said, maybe I might someday. I still got my uniform upstairs. I said, someday maybe I will just give it to a museum or someplace. But, you know, if you give it to museums and stuff, and what they do is they put it in a box and put it down in the basement.
Yeah.
It needs to be shared, Jack. Yeah, shared so people can see it. Look at that. Real dirt out of a ball turret
there. Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah. No, I wouldn't have that one. Gene wanted to see, so why don't we take that to the dry cleaner and get it cleaned up and everything. And I said, no. I want to keep it in its originality.
Look at that. The filth and the sweat of that young guy, Wendy.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And this was brand new when you had it.
Yeah, you know, I when I went to the reunions, these guys would come with their jackets and stuff. But it looked like they never wore them.
Yeah.
But I don't think they were the original A2 jacket, because that's what you want to tape. If you want to tape something, that's the original A2 jacket in here. Now, I don't know whether you can see it. You have to pull this thing down, too. I don't know whether my... Did you get too much of my fingernail there? Or can you get anything on that little... Yeah, see all the writing on that? That's an A2 jacket. That's original issue in 1942. I think it was 42, yeah, when they gave it to me. It's just amazing. It's amazing the stuff that I kept. Can you get that, Wendy?
I was just looking for it. Yeah, I got it.
It's just amazing the things that... I bet you could talk to 1,000 veterans. They'd have a hard time coming up with as much memorabilia as I got.
Yeah. I always remember a chap called Griffiths. Used to come to...
Oh, yeah, was that? Right.
Griffiths.
Yeah.
He used to come. He always used to wear his jacket, didn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, but that wasn't original.
No,
that was one he bought. Went to the army store.
Yeah.
Oh, he was... I despise that guy.
He wasn't very nice.
He was...